Got a lot of things to cover today, so we'll just go ahead and get started here. As you know, we're going to continue what we were doing last week about the spirit, mind, and body hack or biohack. And what that means is ways of accessing your fundamental programs, whether it's biologically, psychologically, emotionally, spiritually. There are fundamental programs that run like carrier waves in radio theory. And then on top of the signal, the carrier wave, there is a signal. For instance, if you're listening to a frequency on your FM radio, you know, 95.9 FM here is a classic rock station I like to listen to in the truck. So that's the carrier wave, the broadcast frequency. And it has no particular sound to it. If there wasn't a signal riding on that carrier wave, like a passenger in a car, you'd hear nothing. You know, imagine that there's a roller coaster going on a track and there's nobody in it. That's kind of like what a carrier wave is. There's a roller coaster or a train going down the track, but there's nobody in it and has no contents. And the signal is the music that's riding on that carrier wave that's in those cars, on the train, in the seats of the roller coaster, riding on the track. And you have fundamental carrier waves that come out of all of your the lower five chakras in your body, energy centers in your body. And these fundamental carrier waves are never shut off. They're never messed up in any way. Because if they were, if one of them stopped broadcasting, you wouldn't exist anymore. All right. The appearance that energy practitioners talk about, some talk about, of a chakra or energy center being blocked has to do with the signal that's riding on the carrier wave is obstructing the basic harmony that the carrier wave has within it. And so what we have are these broadcast frequencies like software programs that run at all five lower centers in your body. And through many centuries of bad habits, dysfunctional psychology, and dissonant ways of living to universal principle, then we've developed these signals that ride on these carrier waves that throw us way out of whack. And we become prone to not just dysfunctional psychology and emotionality, but degenerative diseases, you know, psychological states that are undesirable at best. So what we're looking at doing is hacking back through, and imagine that you're hacking through weeds to reveal a beautiful garden that's behind the weeds. Okay? That's really what we're doing. We're looking at a biological hacking to get through the weeds that have grown up in your biology through toxemia, deficiencies, and excesses. through bad habits and lifestyle, all of that stuff. We're looking at doing the same thing at the emotional level, at the mental level, at the memory level, and at the spiritual level. So as we hack through the weeds at each level, then we're revealing a garden that's always been pristine. It's always been just fine. And this is the way I talk about it when I'm teaching the sound classes in sound energy dynamics. You can hear my voice clearly now, I hope. You know, and there's no distortion. My voice isn't muffled. It's easy to understand my pronunciation, the phonics, the tone. Everything is right there. But if I cover up my mouth like this and then try to talk, then it becomes very difficult for you to understand what I'm saying. See? That's what happens when we get programs laying on top of other programs, on top of other programs through years and decades and multiple lifetimes, where we accumulate one behavior after another behavior, one habit, one thought, one belief, one concept after another. And it's just layer upon layer upon layer on top of this carrier wave. So last week we talked about hacking spiritually into the spiritual body first, because this is a spirit-led life. This isn't body, mind, and spirit. This is spirit, mind, and body. You know, body's the last part of the cascade, not the first part, unless you're looking backwards into the spiritual journey. You remember, we're spirits in a material world. So, hacking into the spirit body, we get through the dogma, the doctrines, the beliefs, and the notions, and we come to the insight that the essential theme of all of the different teachings has always been inner light, inner sound, and inner presence. So no matter what other practices you institute in your life, whether you do your yoga, whether you do your martial arts stuff, your Tai Chi, Qigong, whether you're a runner, a bicyclist, a weightlifter, it doesn't matter what you do. Tennis, racquetball, doesn't matter what you like to do. Swim. What matters is that you do your inner light, inner sound, and inner presence when you're doing it. Because if you take your religious doctrine with you, if you take the baggage of the old ways with you into any other chapter of your life, then you're really strangling yourself of life force. This is where it all starts. It all starts with your spiritual practices. So rather than just letting a little bit of current flow through into your life, as you imagine that with every doctrine that you drop, with every belief system that you let go of, with every, you know, entanglement or attachment you have to any ideas or group or organization, any of that fall away from you, as you let go just a little bit of all of that stuff, then you're releasing blockages, the illusions of blockages, because those are all illusions. You're letting go of those things, and the amount of current that flows through your system increases. You know, this is the way the universe teaches us about flow, teaches us about harmony, teaches us, you know, how to live in harmony with limitless possibilities. First, by setting up a situation where we limit ourselves, by putting up these self-made purgatories, blocks, or eventually, when we realize what we're doing, to remove these obstacles that we've put there. So, with light, sound, and presence, with our unlearning of what we've learned, today I want to spend a good portion of the day jumping down as we've worked through the spiritual biohack. You know, and light, sound, and presence is not a belief, it's not a notion, it's not an understanding, it's only a direct experience. And if you have questions about this, we can field that at the end. You know, I don't believe in it. I experience it. You know, and again, it's been the foundation of my spiritual practices since 1976. It's all I'm doing throughout the whole day. No matter whether I'm talking with you, working outside in the yard, doing anything that I'm doing at the gym this morning, I'm inner light, inner sound, and inner presence. Inner light, inner sound, and inner presence. Continuously, ongoing. It's my ongoing communion with those qualities, is about the best way to say it. So, my background in health as a young guy came because I was very interested in sports. And I was really interested in playing rock drums, you know, as I grew up playing drums. And one of the things I realized as soon as I started playing drums with other guys and girls too, you know, people would play, come over with their instruments and we'd play rock and roll band in mom and dad's backyard, you know, or in the basement. Doesn't take that much energy to sit at a keyboard or play a guitar, but when I'm wailing away at the drums, I'm just exhausted after a while, and I'm thinking, man, you know, I better really, if I really want to play, because when I do something, I do it big. I just don't do it. When I play, I really play. You know, I'm not a drum machine, you know, so... I realized that my interest in sports, my interest in being a rock drummer, and really having fun with all of those things brought me to going to the health food stores. You know, at that time, health food stores were kind of a radical thing. And there was a big supplement store at a farmer's market. He sold all kinds of herbs and exotic stuff. I think a lot of it was illegal, too, at that point. But from all over the world. And the guy, Larry was his name, and he really began to take to me. And as a young guy, he would spend time. I'd listen to him talking to customers, and he was a walking encyclopedia of herbs and European botanicals, American botanicals, different names for them from different cultures, supplements, how they worked, the chemistry that was involved, and I was in awe. You know, and I didn't have much money for this or that or the other thing, and he would always be giving me stuff, you know, or giving me stuff at a great price, and I'd be looking to build muscle and strengthen myself, and as I'm training for sports and doing the things that I'm learning to do in life. So that's basically where I got my beginning, and then as I began to read more and study more on my own, supplementation, miraculous things I saw people and read about people doing with just supplements, curing all kinds of diseases, improving their performance, you know, in sports and in all aspects of life, cognitive function, everything. I thought, you know, there's a lot to this. And I remember talking to my mom about it, who's a nurse. And my mom liked the idea because my mom never wanted to take any medication, but she thought vitamins and herbs, that sounds pretty good. So I remember putting my mom on the program, and she really noticed big improvements of things. So as years went on, as I saw a need in my own life to become vegetarian, to really clean up my diet, reading books from Arnold Arendt. It was one of the old classics. It was called The Mucusless Diet. It sounds pleasant, I know, but the mucus is a big problem, big inflammatory agent within the body. So no dairy. Then I studied about raw and live foods and went juicing, went to the Hippocrates Health Institute in Florida, met the founders, instantly became friends with them, and I became one of the instructors there as well as a student, and helped them build the health educators program for the Hippocrates Institute, which is still standing, and the educators program still stands with a lot of the frameworks that I put into it years ago. And so I'm pretty proud of that. And then Yolanda and I went to the Ann Wigmore Institute, which is another live foods institute in Puerto Rico. And that was pretty interesting as well. Hippocrates does a lot with supplementation, and Ann Wigmore does not. There's no supplementation there. It's fermented foods as well as raw foods. There's no juicing. So it's a much different approach to the whole raw live food thing. And it was great to learn a lot about that. Great chef, an amazing chef and culinary department there. And Yolanda both hated and loved it all at the same time. So, and as the years have gone on, you know, I've done a lot of things in my life. I've been a competitive athlete really on and off throughout my life, a natural bodybuilder, marathon runner, rode my bike across the United States, basically, and with groups of people. Up and down the West Coast, I used to run vegetarian bike trips on the West Coast. Had a number of them. There was a lot of fun in those years. Still like to do that again. It's an amazing thing for people to see the coastal highway when you're on a bicycle, not flying down the road in a car. And as these years have gone on, as we get into the program here, the reason for striving for vibrant health, and I've always wanted to explore the optimal state of health for anyone at any age, is that I never want to be inhibited by my body, or hindered is a better word, by my body, to fulfill what I have in my heart to explore in this life. I never want to be that person that gets up and says, God, I'd love to do that, but I just don't have the energy for that, and I'm not strong enough to do that. I just can't do that anymore. So that's what you have to ask yourself. And we all have to customize our definition of vibrant health, but that's really where it begins, is the idea that you never want to be that person. I don't think you do. You want to be that person that says, I can't do that anymore. You know, can I sprint as fast as I could when I was 25? No, of course not. You know, but I don't train that way anymore. I don't run like that anymore. Can I go out and run a marathon? Well, not today. Am I interested in doing that? No. And my knees thank me for not being interested in that. You know. But I can do anything that I want to do. I ride my bike, I run, walk, I train at the gym. Again, you never want to be limited by your body. Then you become a prisoner. When your dream is outside of what you accept because of your body, then you become a prisoner in your own body. And we can work around most all of it. You know, everybody's got injuries. Heck, I tore up my knees playing college basketball, doing construction. I've torn muscles, more muscles than most people know that they have. And messed up more joints, done everything. But yet, you learn how to train around injuries, train through other injuries. You learn how to heal yourself. You learn everything, and you just keep going. We're built to be in motion. Keep that in mind as we go through all this. We're built to be in motion. The most creative I am in life, the most insights that I realize about the nature of our existence and how to serve all of you better come when I'm active, when I'm training at the gym, when I'm pushing myself, when I'm out there. You know, my ability to play music, to listen, to just all of these things have to do with energy in, energy out. Energy in, energy out. If I put out the energy, then I'm available for the energy, the inspiration, the creativity to flow in, and then I put it back out again in my words or my actions, my endeavor, right? So, in the morning, when you get up in the morning, we're going to do basic must-dos. These are my must-dos. And believe me, I'm not telling you what to do, and I'm not a physician. I'm not giving you any medical advice, but I'm just telling you what I would do if I were you, because really, I am you. I just look different. Okay? All right? So, in the morning, your body is in the elimination cycle. You have three basic eight-hour cycles, and your body in the morning, it's at the tail end of your elimination cycle. So you want to help it through the elimination. This is cellular respiration as well as your regular eliminations in the morning. So one of the great things now, you know, about how the free market system works is that we have a lot of things available to us now that we couldn't even dream about 25 years ago. For instance, I can go to the health food store, I can go to Walmart, and buy organic kombucha from Walmart, fresh. I mean, it's just insane. You can go to the grocery store, buy organic kombucha. What is kombucha? Kombucha is a fermented beverage that you can drink. A lot of the people around here make it, and it's filled with friendly flora and bacteria, good bacteria, and it's got an effervescence to it, a bubbliness to it, fizziness to it. So if you go to the store and buy a bottle, and then I put about 2 inches of that in a glass in the morning. It's the first thing I put in my tummy. I don't. You can do the lemon and water thing, but this is much, much better. Okay, you put about 2 inches of that in a glass. This is general. You can put as much as you want. But then, then I add a little bit of MSM to that. And as Julie was reminding me, you know, my doses of MSM. Again, right now I'm about 208. In pounds. So the amount of MSM that I take that feeds my joints, skin, hair, nails, everything is different than you. So start off with a small hit of MSM, but I buy MSM powder. And I'll give you some of my suppliers at the end of the talk. MSM I buy by the kilo from bulksupplements.com. I'll go over all them later. And you can start off with something like a half a teaspoon if you want to. So what is MSM? MSM is an essential sulfur that's out of all of our, really, it's out of all commercial food. It's been killed out with all the pesticides, insecticides, and everything of conventional grains, greens, everything. And it's really out of a lot of even the organics that you buy, simply because it's washed off. MSM and its full form would be what we would call a DMSO. It's in a natural form. It's the white film on the plants. If you go out to your garden and you see your green leafy vegetables, and you see like the spinach, kale, different things, it has a white film on it. That's MSM. And when we wash it all off. But you're not washing it all off. A lot of it is in the plants. But even in a lot of the organics, that's greatly diminished. I think that's because of the heavy amount of washing and processing they go through to get to us to be pesticide-free and preserved and all that. So you want that. And let me tell you how potent really MSM is. Between sports and construction, particularly. Construction really played havoc with my knees, and I pushed myself really hard in life. And sometime last year, I got to a point where my knees were crunching, you know, when I'm moving around. And if I sat for more than a few minutes, I'd get up and it would be painful. And I was doing MSM. I was doing, you know, my good dietary practices and everything. It's just from me working, just doing all the things that I do. I used to do tile work a lot, had great knee pads, all that stuff, but it doesn't matter. You're still on your knees all the time. In the garden, I'm on my knees. Even though I'm using knee pads, I'm still on my knees. So I was in a lot of discomfort. And my knees would click when I'd be walking around. I'd do my walks and be clicking and crunching, and not good. And so I thought, you know, I've read a couple more articles about MSM, and they said just double your dose of MSM. So I doubled my dose of MSM. And for me, it was about a tablespoon in the morning and a tablespoon of MSM in the evening. Now, I was just doing one in the morning. So as soon as I did one dose in the evening, the very next morning I got up and I had zero knee pain. Zero knee pain, one day. And then I noticed that my left hand, for playing the violin, because, you know, that's in construction, you beat the heck out of your hands too, and doing all kinds of heavy stuff. And all of a sudden I'm able to articulate my fingers really clearly, and there's no stickiness in the tendons, everything's fluid, just like you were soaking your hands in hot water or had a big hand massage before you start playing. Wow. And I even noticed that, again, with construction and things in like repetitive action, I'm a master drywall finisher. I'd be using tools the same way as a young guy all day, every day. And you get that inflammatory condition in your wrist, the carpal tunnel stuff, your repetitive action. So I'd have a hand go numb, you know, left hand, right hand go numb, my knees. I mean, this is not acceptable, you know. And I'd be doing my tunings, be doing other things. I'm feeling great, except I'm walking around and my hand's going numb. Can't play drums with a numb hand. You can't play violin with a numb hand. You know, not acceptable. So as soon as I took the second dose of MSM, my right hand, my left hand, I don't have any numbness ever. And that's because it acts also as an anti-inflammatory. And I was already taking curcumin, which is another anti-inflammatory. But the MSM is a super lubricant for all of your joints. It also feeds the hair follicles, feeds your nails. It smooths out all the ridges in your nails. you know, balances everything out. Again, it's just that essential sulfur that we're missing. That's a huge nutrient in your body. It has a lot of antioxidant qualities as well as anti-inflammatory qualities. MSM is really a miracle food, and everybody should be messing around with the experimentation of that and just play with it. That's the very first thing I do. So I do my kombucha with MSM, and if you're training, if you're exercising, a good thing to add into that is your is an amino acid powder that I also get from bulk supplements. Doesn't really have any taste. It dissolves easily in there, and it's a good way to get it in. Amino acids are the fundamental building blocks of all proteins. So your body's in the elimination cycle. So your body uses energy to eliminate metabolic waste products. So you want to be able to not just help your body cleanse, but you throw some amino acids in there. Your body doesn't have to digest them. Doesn't have to break them down because they're already pre-digested proteins. They're the amino acids themselves. They're raw. They go right into your bloodstream. They go right to wherever you need them. So they help you recover from exercise if you're going to exercise or train in the morning, which is the best time to train, of course. You know, and it just helps you, your body heal. Because as your body uses energy trying to eliminate, your body's looking for resources to heal itself. Because most people are rather deficient in their reserves, so your body scavenges from wherever it can, which we'll cover later, to heal itself from its daily cleansing. All right, so that's how you begin. And the friendly flora, the bacteria, now they call it the biome. We used to call it friendly flora. From the kombucha goes right into your system, and as soon as you take that, the other ingredient I add to this, which is essential for your digestive juices, your hydrochloric acid, is your Bragg's apple cider vinegar. I take a tablespoon of that, throw it in with the kombucha, put it in with the MSM, amino acid powder if you want to, and I'll give you the one to get, and I know people will take that and go, God, what is he having me take in the morning? You know, but there's many different flavors of kombucha, and you can get the one that you like. There's all kinds of local breweries. I don't know what it is in different parts of the country, but you know how there's beer breweries? Well, there's kombucha breweries here in Florida. All right, and it's just kind of how we go here. And the kombucha breweries have all kinds of flavors of kombucha. And they're in the local stores all the time. And they even sell kombucha through beer taps at some of the health food stores. You know, you bring your bottle and you buy how much you're going to buy. That's how much they sell. That's how big a deal it is here over these last years. And it's amazing for your body. You know, all my grandkids do it every day. They do a glass of kombucha every day. Everybody's on it. So that should be a must. As soon as I do that, I put on some hot water. All right. And I only drink distilled water for coffee or for tea. You know, we steam our vegetables, cook stuff. We use distilled water for everything, even though I built a great water system for the house. It's not good enough. It's not good enough for what I want to do. You know, remember I had a deep artesian well dug when we bought the house, had a brand new well, everything's in. It's as good as you're going to get it, but you still want to demineralize the water completely because the purpose of water is not to mineralize you because you don't absorb any of the minerals from water because they're in the wrong form. Those are ionically bonded minerals. I don't mean ionic minerals. That's a different marketing thing, different physics principle. There's three bonds in basic molecular science. You have ionic bonds, which are the tight bonds. That's the bonds that, let's say you have iron that's in your well water. That's what that is. That's an ionic bond, tightest bond there is. It's not a available bond. The next one is called a covalent bond. That's shareable bond. That's like you eating the spinach that was watered from that well, that took the minerals from that well water from the dirt, which is also ionic bonds, broke those bonds down through parts of photosynthesis, break down the ionic bonds, and now you have covalent bonds, which is why you can eat spinach in a big salad and get all that iron out of it. Okay? Then beyond that, then you have colloidal bonds, and then you have ionic bonds that occur in different types of situations in nature that we don't need to get into. Now, that's an hour discussion all by itself, but just understand that you don't get any minerals out of spring water, out of your well water, and that's not its purpose. The purpose of water in your life is to hydrate you. That's it. Hydrate you and to aid in the carrying of nutrients and the carrying of waste products throughout and out your body. That's what the water does. It's not supposed to be a nutrient. It's supposed to be a carrier. All right. So I use distilled water, heat up my water. And after about 5 minutes of doing your kombucha, you'll feel a warmth in your tummy. And you really do. That's the kombucha, but it's also the MSM. And you have lots of ciliations in the bottom of your stomach that begin to get cleansed by the kombucha. And the MSM begins to get absorbed as it passes through into the small intestine. And it's a warm feeling going through your whole system. It's a great thing to have going on in your body. All right. And that apple cider vinegar that you're using, the reason you're doing that is that as you clean the ciliations in your stomach, that Bragg's apple cider vinegar works to replenish. It triggers a hydrochloric acid reaction in your stomach, and most people are severely deficient in hydrochloric acid. It makes them unable to digest a lot of foods properly. It creates a whole cascade of problems as years and decades go on. So that's just something I do every day. And you can read for an hour about Bragg's apple cider vinegar, and that'll give you a lot to consider about ways to use it in your life. It's a great product. Paul Bragg was the founder of the Bragg's company. His granddaughter, Patricia, still runs it today. Paul Bragg opened the first health food store in North America, and he called it a health food store as a satire, as a joke. And it, of course, turned into what you have today all over. So with my hot water going, I don't drink coffee in the morning anymore. I used to love to drink coffee in the morning after I did my morning juice or whatever I was doing in that chapter of my life. But I find that coffee was upsetting my stomach, even though I make really good. I perk my coffee. I don't drip my coffee. I do all these things. I get all the oils from the coffee, which are all its nutritional values, all of this, only organic coffee. But it still was upsetting my stomach. So I found that tea doesn't upset my stomach. But I like a bit of caffeine. You know, so I drink a regular black tea. You can drink Earl Grey if you like that. Yolanda likes that. So we tend to have tea in the morning. And as I make my tea with my distilled water, when you're making herbal teas and tinctures, also pulls more out of the herbs. So the tea is stronger. You get a stronger concentration of your herbal remedy that you're making. All right? And in that, I put about a a half to three quarters of a tablespoon for me. You'll have to gauge it to your size of coconut oil. I use my raw organic coconut oil. Coconut oil is full of a really important substance called MCTs. And just to give you the real short, MCTs means medium chain triglycerides. You have short, medium, and long chain triglycerides. Medium chain triglycerides are a preferred fuel in your body. All right. And triglycerides are, of course, sugars, glycerides, right? And your short chains are your quick up and quick down. That's your soda pop and all the different things that the kids used to drink, you know. And and of course, sugars in everything. But rather than telling you what not to do, I'm not as concerned about what to get you to stop doing, because that'll happen naturally. If you just start adding good things into your system, then your inherent harmony will say, oh, I just don't want that, or I don't want as much of that. You know, that's the best way I've found to help people over these years. So let's add the coconut oil into your diet. And if you want more, if you're training, if you feel as though you want to do some weight loss or weight gain, because MCT oil, you can go to the store and buy organic MCT oil, and there's the cheap version, which you don't want, that comes from palm oil. Stay away from that. You want it that comes from coconuts. So you can just buy a bottle of MCT oil and just use that. You can put that in your green drink, your protein. You can put it in different things. It has no taste whatsoever, so you can even mix it up. I really like a tahini dressing for salads, you know, things like that. You can throw a couple tablespoons in there. You can get it in throughout the day, and that'll help your metabolism balance itself out. So if you're underweight and you can't gain weight, a lot of older people get under an ideal weight, and their bones get weak, their muscles get weak, all of this. A lot of that can be helped with MCTs. All right. And likewise, if you're heavier than you want to be, if your body composition isn't where you want it to be, MCTs will, because of the efficiency of that fuel, your body will work to optimize its place. You know, it'll bring your weight, your body composition to an optimal state. Now, your bone mass and muscle mass are up to you to deal with, which we'll talk about that. But weight, body composition, can be done just metabolically when you look at the chemistry of how the body is trying to maintain an equilibrium. All right, so that's and because I've always liked coffee, but I don't want to drink coffee in the morning. There is a coffee substitute that's made from dandelion. And I think it's just called Dandy Blend. And we get that at the health food store, or she buys it online in a big bag because we go through it. It's great cold, and it's great hot. And I add some of that into my tea with my coconut oil in the morning, and I just let it steep for five minutes or so, because it's hot. You know, it's too hot to drink. And the benefit of Dandy in there is that it really cleans your liver, because dandelion is a great liver cleanser. So it's in the morning. I've done my kombucha. I've done my, you know, my hydrochloric acid from the apple cider vinegar. I've got my MSM going in there, the essential sulfur, you know, and now you add your cup of tea. You get a little bit of a lift from caffeine from your tea, or you can do decaf stuff if you don't want to do that. And then you have still the cleansing action going on from the dandy going on. And the coconut oil, your preferred fuel, is going in and your body's going, oh, all right, here we go. Got some good fuel going on here. So soon after I do all that, I'm ready to go to the gym. For me, you know, that's our cycle. And we'll talk about all that in a minute. I got a lot to get through. I can see why Vibrant Health used to take 6 to 8 hours. Okay, you know, this is just an awful lot. Let's get into supplements. All right, so this is all being recorded, so you don't have to worry about getting it all down. But you know, just do what you can here. Early in the morning, your early morning regime, if you're over 25 years old, which I assume most everybody here is over 25 years old, you're going to need to take DHEA, not 7-keto or 5-keto DHEA, but regular straight-up DHEA and pregnenolone. And I take 50 milligrams of DHEA and 50 milligrams of pregnenolone, not progesterone. I like progesterone, too. I think that's really beneficial as we get older. But 50 milligrams of pregnenolone. And your body takes good cholesterol, your HDL, and it converts your good cholesterol, your HDL, into pregnenolone through the pituitary and the pineal. And then from good cholesterol to pregnenolone, then it creates DHEA. Then from DHEA, it creates testosterone, estrogen, progesterone, cortisol, all the different hormones. And hormones are like generals in the army. And the generals direct what the troops do. The troops are your proteins. And the proteins then carry nutrients to where they're going to be. So your proteins are being directed by these hormones, the generals. And your hormone levels drop dramatically, partially because of nutritional deficiencies in our diet, environmental contaminants, air and water, stressors in our life, and then toxins that accumulate within our bodies. And as our hormones drop, they drop almost 50 to 60% by the time you're 30 years of age. It could be earlier than that now. That's what it was years ago. So, and people, the medical community, if you get tested and you're 50 and you've got like negligible production of pregnenolone and DHEA, the doctor will say, well, that's normal. Well, yeah, it's normal because everybody's walking around just about dead. So what you want to do is optimize, and they found that indigenous cultures, when you go to people that live outside of the Western world and you would go to see how people live very simple lives away from all of the stuff that we're involved in here, when people live just eating organically, naturally, in their immediacy of their environment, then their hormone levels would stay at about a 25 to 28, 30-year person until they're 70, 75 years of age. And this is how you had researchers going down, and you'd have 70, 75-year-old men having children, fathering children. You have women still having their cycles regularly with no menstrual cramps, nothing, no problems at all, up into their upper 60s and 70s. You'd have no cancers, no degenerative diseases, none of this kind of stuff. And, of course, all that changes when Western man shows up and starts bringing all of our advancements to them. You know, so we're supposed to maintain our levels. So don't let the doctors fool you. Oh, your hormone levels are fine. Mm-hmm. All right. So when you take DHEA and pregnenolone, it brings up your hormone levels because you're augmenting what your body's trying to do, which is produce these hormones. Because the glands become atrophied, fluoride, chlorine in the water, all these things atrophy the production from the pineal and the pituitary glands. The secretions no longer set up those propagation chains. So we supplement that. So now your body says, oh, here's the raw material. Now I can build these hormones. Okay. All right. So now as you raise up your levels of hormones, some of the things we also have to do is balance that out, because hormones operate optimally in ratios, specific ratios. And pretty much everybody walking around in the Western world is estrogen dominant. And estrogen dominant has to do with not just being surrounded by women, but it has to do with being in a culture where we're surrounded by plastics that are gassing off. You have pesticides and insecticides, which are they inhibit certain metabolic functions and block certain hormone receptors, and they become estrogen drivers. So you have all types of factors here that combine to become a huge hormonal mess inside your body. So there, as you take your DHEA and your pregnenolone, you want to take another product called DIM, D-I-M. And DIM is basically an extract from broccoli, okay? But you'd have to eat tons of broccoli every day, all right? So I just take DIM. And I take 200 to 400 milligrams of DIM per day. And 200 to 400 milligrams of DIM per day, what does that do? It acts like a sponge, sucking the estrogens out of your body. And it primarily sucks the phytoestrogens and the xenohormones. Those are the fake estrogens that block up the receptors, because your body needs good estrogen, men and women, just like women need good testosterones. All right? And when you take DIM, DIM sucks the synthetics and the contaminants in that are hormone mimickers out of the body. And it's really beneficial. Everybody should be taking it. Everybody should be taking it. So then we go on to ubiquinol. And ubiquinol is a concentrated form of coenzyme Q10. And I like that better than CoQ10. Some people like taking CoQ10 better, but my research, my experimentation, I take 200 milligrams of ubiquinol. And coenzyme Q10 regulates the oxygen flow into and out of every cell of your body. And you know, all of the aerobic functions, you have two types of functions in your body, aerobic and anaerobic. And you have the functions of aerobic nature that are all guided by CoQ10 in your body. And if you don't have enough CoQ10, which almost nobody does, then it's an inefficient use and you end up being in deprivation and you end up having a less oxygenated environment than what you really should have, which is another whole series of problems that we have in our culture as part of the problem with wearing masks, is the low oxygen environment. So 200 milligrams of ubiquinol is probably equivalent to about 400 to 500 milligrams of CoQ10 in what it does in your body. So a lot of professional athletes will take 200 milligrams of ubiquinol 2 to 3 times a day because they notice that it increases their aerobic capacity and their endurance for cycling, running, you know, different things like that, the endurance sports, tennis players, marathon runners, everybody. So, but I take 200 milligrams a day, and it makes a difference. And you can read about great studies where people were scheduled for heart surgeries, for bypass surgeries, stents, different things, and balloon surgeries. and then they were put on CoQ10 and ubiquinol in the latest studies, and they find that 6 weeks of being on ubiquinol, and they didn't have to have any surgery anymore. Because their body, when they had enough oxygen for cellular respiration, cleared out all the debris in their heart. I mean, that's just amazing, you know. But they don't want to tell you that, doctor, but that's, you know, we know that. So a cofactor to ubiquinol is PQQ. And just look up PQQ. And PQQ works on the mitochondria in your body. Mitochondria is of course, what produces your ATP. That's your big energy, your big battery source inside every cell of your body. And it directly has, because CoQ10 and ubiquinol are its cofactor, it really works on your heart a whole lot, really strengthens your heart. And the PQQ also has, and I think it has to do with the regulatory cofactor with the ubiquinol. It seems to have, there's some new studies out about how it affects cognitive function. It improves your cognitive function. So that's great news. And that's an inexpensive supplement. So I take 200 milligrams of ubiquinol, 20 milligrams of PQQ, and I take about 3,000 milligrams of vitamin C, usually twice a day, in the morning and in the afternoon. And I don't take it as I take it as a calcium ascorbate, not as sodium ascorbate. Sodium ascorbate is an acidic form of C, but like an ester C, that's too sweet. I don't use those. I just buy the calcium ascorbate, and those are more alkaline. And the sodium is just too acidic for me. And it's too acidic for most people. You shouldn't really be doing it. And now let's beef up your immune system. And remember, you have no immune system, okay? Nobody has an immune system. That's really, I wish the doctors, and I wish even the health practitioners would stop talking about that, because you don't have a system that's called your immune system. It's not like your skeletal system, your vascular system, your cardiovascular system, your nervous system. You don't have a immune system. Your immune system is the ability of all of the systems of your body, all of them, to work together in concert, like all the musicians in an orchestra playing together to adapt to an ever-changing series of circumstances in your world. That's your immune system. Okay, that is your immune system. So you have to take care of everything, and that's what we're doing here. All right. By getting back to the foundations of how you work at a cellular level. So, as you heard, back when the COVID thing, the great scamdemic started, I was yelling about everybody should be taking zinc and iodine. Zinc and iodine, zinc and iodine, zinc and iodine. And actually, there's a three part to that: zinc, iodine, and selenium. Because selenium goes as the cofactor to iodine. And there's a couple different forms of zinc. And basically, as long as it's a chelated zinc, which means it's more bioavailable, then you're pretty much good to go. But I like zinc glycinate, okay? That's the one that I'm taking. And I take 30 to 60 milligrams per day, all right? And some people take more. I don't think it's necessary. If you get up around 200 to 300 milligrams of zinc per day like that, you know, you can, if you overdose in zinc, you'll notice things like you can start to lose hair. And it's not a permanent thing. It's just your body flipping out, doesn't know what to do because it throws everything askew inside your system, okay? But 30 to 60 milligrams is really good to take. And that fortifies the cellular membrane around your body, you know, around every cell in your body, rather, and therefore your whole body, right? So when you take iodine, now, sourcing is important. The classic holistic form of iodine that I used to take is called Lugol's. And Lugol's is a good iodine, and I took that for a number of years. I first took it when I was afflicted with the prostate thing that just kind of erupted as if out of nowhere, okay, which I'll talk about that for men's health in a minute. But that was a number of years ago, and we cleared that up just like that. And well, when I began to research iodine, I find that, you know, Lugol's is good. Lugol's helped me dramatically. It helps everybody dramatically. It's a good product. But there's different ways of extracting iodine. And one of the alternative news sources that I listen to, InfoWars, I really like his iodine. He makes two forms of iodine. They're made from rare earth crystals deep in the earth, and Lugol's is made from seaweed. And the problem with a lot of the seaweed is contaminants, of course. So how pure is it now? All we can do is hope that Lugol's is good. I know that the X2 is called X2, and it doesn't taste bad. It's good. You can either put it in water, drink it down, and I just put it on my tongue, and I just roll it around in my mouth and swallow it every day. I put about two to four drops of X2. And everybody's deficient in iodine, everybody's deficient in zinc, and everybody's deficient in selenium. Selenium, again, as the cofactor. And he makes a really good selenium, too, at the InfoWars, and many times he'll sell it as a two-pack. You'll buy a X2, that's the iodine, comes in an eyedropper bottle, and then you buy a bottle of the BioTrue selenium. I take one selenium each day, that's 200 micrograms, MCGs. You do that, and you're fortifying your internal environment. Iodine is a huge antibiotic, antiviral. It strengthens your whole body. Your body becomes physically stronger when you're taking iodine. A lack of iodine in your diet has been directly linked to a lower IQ. You know, birth defects, all types of things from low iodine. And that all became apparent when they started weeding that out of the food supply, out of salt, by over-processing salts, all of that stuff. That's why you need to use really good salt, not just garbage salt, but still take your iodine every day. I do. These are things that I do every day. These are my must-do every days. And then, even though I'm in Florida, and I'm out in the sun most every day, I still take D3, and I take one or two gels because the oil-based vitamin D is more bioavailable than the capsules. Something I didn't know until recently. The studies show that the capsule form, for some reason, is not that available to your system. It's probably because it's a fat-soluble vitamin, and the way it goes, actually D3 is a hormone, but they call it a vitamin. So I take the D3 one gel. Each one is about 5,000 units. And 5,000 units comes out to about 125 micrograms, I think is the equivalent. But they're usually measured in IUs. And then there's something that Yolanda wanted us to add that I've been adding, and I think is a really valuable thing to share with you. It's called we do a combination of quercetin and bromelain. Quercetin is an antioxidant. It's a flavonoid found in a lot of different foods, vegetables, fruits. And it's a really strong antioxidant. And if you don't know what an antioxidant is something that bonds to free radicals. And free radicals are not of a particular political association. They are molecules in your body that wreak havoc. Free radicals look for things to bond, and then they take them apart, kind of dissect things, create a whole cascade of destruction where they go. And one free radical will create more free radicals, creates more free radicals, and it's just a real mess inside your body. So you look for free radical scavengers, and free radical scavengers in our languaging now. Years ago, we called them free radical scavengers. Now we call them antioxidants. You know, and anti meaning against, an oxidative, you know, you want to have something that's going to be non-oxidative, antioxidative. And so the quercetin is a really good antioxidant. And you take that, and the dose is about 500 milligrams, and that's one capsule. It's an easy take. They're inexpensive. And I think it's just a good thing to throw in your recipe, because we develop free radicals. We develop free radicals by stress is one of the ways. And there's two kinds of stress. There's constructive and destructive stress. So we have them both. My constructive stress is when I stress at the gym, when I'm out building the sound tables and the sound pads and I'm doing different things in the yard. That's positive stress, challenging myself out for a bike ride or a walk, right? But destructive stress is living in the world with the pervading insanity that's going on all around us. And, you know, then if people are worried about how you're going to pay this month's bills and what's going on and blah, 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 blah. Relationship stressors, you know, all of it, you know, these things are destructive stressors. Both create free radicals in your system. So you want to try to flush them out as much as possible. By fortifying your cell walls with your zinc, your iodine, your selenium, you're clearing up your borders, okay? And clearing up your borders at a cellular level allows the border guard, meaning like customs and immigration, but at every cell of your body, to say, you're not coming in, but you can come in. You're not coming in, and you're definitely not coming in, but you can come in. And that's because you've cleared out the receptors, so estrogens that match can get in, you know, and testosterones, but things that don't match, you know, the lock and key system of your body, then they won't get in. Mimickers are all cleared out. See, the antioxidants clear out your estrogen mimickers, xenohormones, and all the free radicals that are destroying stuff going on. Just like DIM works to clear out the fake hormones. So the more antioxidants that you can take, really the better in your body. That's why I do a lot of fresh juices, because they're full of antioxidants. I made like 40 ounces of fresh grapefruit juice today. Sucked that down after I got back from the gym. You know, on a completely empty stomach, just throw that in the tank, because it just goes right into your bloodstream, full of antioxidants, full of enzymes. It just flushes your system completely, feeds your system. And so the quercetin and bromelain. Bromelain is a unique enzyme in that it's only found in nature in pineapples. Now, If you've never eaten a pineapple that's fresh, like right off the plant, then you're really missing something. I mean, it's an amazing thing. But even the pineapples you get at the store are still filled with bromelain. And it's at their highest concentration of the enzymes on the top quarter of the pineapple, okay? The whole pineapple has bromelain in it, but the top quarter is going to be the richest in enzymes, just for information. But you should eat the whole thing. And what bromelain does, what's unique about it is that it works in an acid or an alkaline environment, unlike most other enzymes. Most enzymes have a preferred kind of environment. They'll work, but not that well. But bromelain works great no matter where it is. And it's really potent at breaking down all forms of protein, plant protein, animal protein, all of it. So the supplement that we get from Vitacost has bromelain and quercetin in it. And I just take one of them a day. You know, that's a pretty simple one. And if you have problems, if you have difficulties in your system with inflammation, and most people have inflammation problems either from being too sedentary, or from exercising too much, or from an acid environment. You know, there's all kinds of different factors at work there. Then I throw curcumin in my diet, not regularly. You know, I do it a couple times a week, depending on what I'm feeling. And we noticed for our dogs that it immediately took away any kind of arthritic stiffness that they had. And it was great. You could watch Loki, the Siberian. He could be kind of, you could tell him in the morning he was stiff. You give him a curcumin, and by nighttime he was great, and he'd be good for a couple days just from one tablet stuck in his food. That's the basic. I don't know, that sounds not basic, but that's the basic supplement program. I do also, I take a B50 and I take a B complex 50. You can get a B25, 50, 75, or 100. And the one that's the most valuable for me, my size, now you're little, if you're half my size, maybe you could do a B25. You know, but you could do a B50 and just not do them as regularly as I do, right? Because B complex, being a very water soluble vitamin, will go right out of your system in 3 to 4 hours. So I do it 2-3 times a day. You know, and it just keeps me moving forward. And there is a, let's see, how can I put it quickly? There's so much to tell you. The first vitamins that your body goes to deal with stress are your B-complex vitamins. And, you know, I wish people had known this all this last year with all the stressors that people have been under. Yeah, but your body will suck all of the B vitamins right out of your body. Hang on, let me see. We did give them some different things. We tried, Deb. The question is, do we give our dog, both of our dogs passed away this year, unfortunately. Loki was 15, and Bella was close to 15. We don't really know how old she was, but she was right up there too. They were both rescues. So that's the B complex. Yeah, that's the only other thing I'm going to add right now for our supplement. Let's get through two other things here. I'm known for my green drink. All right. My green drink is not a green smoothie. That's a different thing completely. I love green smoothies too. You jam a bunch of veggies in the blender, you know, and you do it all up and there you go. That's great. That's a different animal completely. My green drink is a superfood that is your multivitamin. See, instead of taking a multivitamin, mineral, and element, then I was been thinking all these years about, you know, Hippocrates, of course, you know, let your food be your medicine and let your medicine be your food. So if you're looking for a multivitamin, why? I mean, to get a good multivitamin, you're going to spend $150 a month. I mean, it's insane what it is. And I don't really like that form. So you can get superfoods. And really, my green drink has gone through different variants over the years. And I have to make one variant with you today because of supplies. And I just got off the phone with one of the suppliers, and I'll talk to you about that here. My green drink is something that you make, and it can last a couple days. And you sip on it throughout the day, and you're loading nutrients, minerals, elements, vitamins, minerals, protein, amino acids, the whole thing, into your system throughout the whole day. Just take a mouthful and go. And it's amazing what it does for your body. The supplements give your body some raw material to do what it should be doing metabolically. And the green drink now goes in there. And now here's all the raw material for all the vitamins to do what they need to do, all the elements to do what they need to do. See, your supplements enable your body to do what it should do metabolically. So now that we've adjusted the carburetor, you know, and got things running, the timing running right with your cellular respiration, we get your hormones balanced. So, you know, the metabolic clock and tempo and rhythm of things is going well. Now let's add the raw nutrients, vitamins, minerals, and elements, and let your body do what it's going to do. So the original green drink is basically what we're doing here, except that I can't get good chlorella anymore. And this is a problem. This is a problem for us because I've got sources all over the place, of course. And my go-to source for 30 years has been Stockic up in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, up in the UP. Stockig is a bee aviary of multiple generations, and they have the best bee pollen, raw honey, propolis, royal jelly, everything ever. Now, I could get stuff locally, but I love the family. You know, the founder, the old guy knows me, and so I just deal with them. And so here's the recipe for green drink. All right. So the green drink starts off with spirulina and chlorella. These are two superfood algaes. Chlorella has a cracked cell wall, has a little different amino acid profile than spirulina. Spirulina is really richer in chlorophyll. and other nutrients than chlorella. They complement each other really well. So doing them both is really good. And they're not that expensive to do, which I look for bang for the buck when I'm doing all this. And then bee pollen. Bee pollen's one of the key perfect foods in nature. All of your amino acids, essential and non-essential amino acids, all the nucleic acids, everything you want is right there in your raw honey. I buy a 10-pound bag of honey, of bee pollen from Stockic, and it lasts me about 6 to 8 months. And I break it down into small freezer bags, and I keep the one I'm using in the refrigerator, keep the others in one of the freezers. You know, and they technically say I don't have to do that. I can just keep it all in the refrigerator. But they also say it doesn't injure it or break it down or anything by keeping it in the freezer. I just keep it in the freezer. It's more organized, and it's I just think it's better. So spirulina and chlorella, start off with, if you're just taking them for the first times in your life, start off with about a quarter teaspoon of each of those. Bee pollen, start off with a nice round tablespoon. That's a whole food. When my daughter was growing up, I used to put 4 or 5 tablespoons of bee pollen in a little bowl, hand it to her when we were sitting around, and she would just snack on it. She called it bee candy. It's delicious, tastes great, just melts in your mouth when it's fresh like that. And their bee pollen tastes really good. So, spirulina, chlorella, bee pollen. And classically, in my green drink, I would add 2 other powders to it. And one is kelp powder, and the other is dulse powder. Not flakes. Don't get flakes. You'll be hating life. You can use that as a seasoning if you want to, but why ruin the food? But get powder. And you use just a little bit, like an eighth of a teaspoon of kelp, an eighth of a teaspoon of dulse. Those are, of course, seaweeds, and their roots go several miles down into the earth, and they are hugely rich in essential minerals and elements. So when you add just a touch of that, of each of those, into your green drink, you're getting a complete mineral base, all your amino and nucleic acids, chlorophyll, huge amounts of chlorophyll, vitamins, minerals, just everything. That's a really simple green drink. And then if you want to beef it up, like I beef mine up because I'm training at the gym and I'm demanding a lot of myself, I add some protein. You can either add yellow pea or green pea protein if you want to. Or this month I'm using, I change proteins around. I'm using hemp protein. All right. And because I'll drink the green drink over about 2 days, I make enough for about 2 days. And you have to gauge yourself. You know, so I drink it a lot. You know, so I make a pretty big batch. And you can adjust your quantities of each of these things, you know, the spirulina, chlorella if you can get it, bee pollen, kelp, dulse, and your protein according to how many doses you think you're going to get out of it. Your body will absorb between 30 and 40 grams of protein at a pop depending upon your body size. So I'll put 150 grams of protein in my green drink because I'll have it over the course of a couple of days. And I start drinking it at 6 in the morning. And And there's one other ingredient I've been adding for its antioxidant qualities. It's called pomegranate powder. And pomegranate powder has a magic ingredient called ellagic acid. And ellagic acid is a huge antioxidant and anti-inflammatory agent. The best place to buy that is from bulkfoods.com. No, bulk supplements, I'm sorry. Let me make sure. Yes, it's bulk supplements. Bulksupplements.com. That's one of the two places that I go to for everything. And you can just do that to your taste. It doesn't really have too much of a flavor or texture change to your drink. Also in my green drink, I put a little bit of raw honey, which I also get from StockTick. That's where I get the bee pollen and the spirulina from. Now the problem, as I mentioned, I use chlorella in there too, but the chlorella that I have, I bought last year. And the owner of StockTick, the founder, I happened to call there today to find out why I can't get chlorella from them anymore. And he said, because you can't get chlorella anywhere but China now, and I won't buy anything made in China, any food product at least. And I said, oh, no, I won't either. I just bought some, because I just bought chlorella and spirulina from one of the other big herbal companies, and I'm returning it. Because this all comes from China. I won't touch that. I will not touch it. And and if they won't take it back, because some of those companies have a restocking fee, which I'm not going to pay because it's not a big order, you know, then I'll just use it as plant food or something. But I'm not going to eat it. Because you can't really verify the conditions that it was grown under, even if it says organic on it. A lot of those things come from China, and they're filled with heavy metals and all kinds of contaminants. And I won't have it, and I won't recommend it to anybody. So spirulina, we still get from a pristine area of Japan. Sometimes they get it from Hawaii. They have great spirulina farms in Hawaii. And but as far as chlorella, you can't find it in Hawaii now. You can't find real Hawaiian chlorella anymore. I don't know why. I've been looking. Deb, one of our ladies here on the call, she's from Hawaii. If you can find it, you let me know, because I can't find it anywhere. And make sure it's really from there if you can find it. So. Juicing, real quick. The purpose of juicing is not the same as a smoothie. So don't let the people tell you that, oh, I don't need juicing, I'm doing my green smoothie. You know, your green smoothie where you blend up all your stuff in the blender. The purpose of juicing is to get all of the fiber out of your drink. When you take all the fiber out of your drink, then you're eliminating your digestive reaction. You're minimizing an insulin reaction, and you're maximizing the assimilation of all the electrolytes, the magic that's in juice, into your system. Totally different animal. Juicing is like mainlining. It's like injecting nutrients and organic water, electrolytes, enzymes directly into your bloodstream. Within a minute after you drink a glass of juice, it's already pouring into your bloodstream through diffusion in your small intestine. But your smoothie, when you throw all the veggies in the blender, then it becomes a food. And it's great to do because it breaks it down. It's easy to digest for people. And when you eat your food that way, when you're drinking it, again, it's easy to digest, easy to assimilate, easy to eliminate, and it's an on-the-go type of a thing. It's great to do. Don't confuse it with juicing, and don't confuse it with your green drink. It's different. A smoothie, a green smoothie, is like a meal. Okay, a meal is not a multivitamin. Your green drink is your multivitamin. Juicing is just injecting super powerful food into your body for healing, rejuvenation, you know, all types of benefits. But you gotta, when I make juice, I filter all of the pulp out of it when it comes out of the juicer. And, you know, I'm the nutrition guy. I've got the best juicers you can buy. And I still run it through a filter to get a high density screen to get all the pulp out of it. Because there's still fiber in there, even when it's filtered. You filter it again. Different animal completely. The chemistry of juicing is different than the chemistry of a green drink or of your green smoothie. All right. So, I got this one question I will take. And easily to say I could do another 6 hours without ever getting up out of the chair. So, we're going to have to wrap this for today. Irene.
Hi, Christopher. Hello, I am in New York. I am in New York in a nightmare. You don't want to know.
No, you're not. You're wonderful.
We're having a seasonal snowfall for 3 days now. You can't go outside. And this city is a wreck, you know, because it has become a socialist paradise.
It has. Yes, it has. You're right, Irene. Irene lives in New York, in case you don't know, everybody.
And I recently, I had the eye doctor, Diane Burstein, who was number one in the world. And she retired recently. And she diagnosed me that I am losing my sight. So I don't know if you have any magic bullet for that. She gave me a liquid luminal eye drops to try, and they just burned my eyes. It's similar to if you put a match in right into
yes,
my eyes.
Yes, I do. I do have something.
God.
I do have something that's absolutely unbelievable. Yolanda had done research and began to experiment with actually dissolving a little bit of MSM, that powder that I talked about earlier, that sulfur,
yep,
in pure water, right? And right,
yeah,
Deb Bilberry. And then take an eyedropper, and it doesn't burn at all. Because I don't like eye drops. I'm not a...
Yeah. But I was forced in a way. I had no choice.
Right.
And
so when she puts the MSM in my eyes, it doesn't burn at all, doesn't feel at all uncomfortable. But what she noticed is that she put the MSM in her eyes, and then the next morning when she got up, she could see perfectly clearly without putting her glasses on. She started looking around the room, and she could grab her glasses because she could see them. And she said normally she has to remember where she puts them because it's not, you know, she doesn't see that well without her glasses and for distance. And so that's one thing. And then
I have a lazy eye. My right eye is 20, I have about 25% vision on it, but I had perfect vision in the left eye. And it's the most unbelievable thing because it happened so quickly. And my vision is okay right now, but I feel when I wake up in the morning, everything is sort of faded, and I blink a few times, and then I see, okay, but that okay is not the level of vision that I used to have.
Well, try that, Irene. And there's a couple people that said you can just get MSM eye drops,
Okay.
And the other herb that will help your eyesight is called bilberry. Deb sends that over. And
is it P-I or
B-I, Bill, like bilberry.
Oh, bilberry. Okay, yeah, I'm familiar.
Try that too. And come on
Thank
next
you.
Week. Yes, you come on next week if you can. We'll talk more. I want to take Daniel's question, and then I want to wrap up for the day. I've already been on long enough.
Yeah.
Thank you, Irene.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. Sure. Bye. Daniel?
Hey, Christopher. I know that you said you wanted to be super quick, so I'm going to make it super quick. I just wanted to say awesome, awesome, awesome conversation tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
Some really valuable tips that, interestingly enough, a friend of mine actually recommended a couple years ago that I start taking MSM, and I had never even heard of it. But, everything that you said about the joint, absolutely, like no creaking, no cracking, no squeaking, all that stuff. And then all I wanted to say, the reason I actually punched in, was because I've heard from two people. Once was decades ago from an elementary school teacher, and then another one was relatively recently watching a video of a stand-up comedian. And Irene said that she had a lazy eye. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. What both of them said for a lazy eye is to actually put an eye patch on the eye that focuses normally. And what that does is apparently what both of them said is the reason for the lazy eye, at least in most cases, is the muscles that actually
right.
focus the eye are just a little bit weaker in that one. And so putting the eye patch on the stronger eye forces those muscles to become stronger and have the weak eye focus.
That's
so
great.
Just
great,
try the
Daniel.
Eye patch, for like if you can, as much as you can while you're awake, and try that for a few weeks and see what that works.
That is fantastic. That's really good. And Irene heard that. So I will ask her how she's doing with that next week. And that is great. That's just a great way to train your body. Good thinking. And thank you for that, Daniel.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Christopher.
Yep. All right, everybody. Good day. And, you know, we're just cracking the surface of my vibrant health world. When I used to teach it as a workshop, it was 2 8-hour days, and people were basically crawling out of the door when they got done. You know, it's just a huge experience, and it's exhausting to teach because I'm a nonstop information dispensary system once, you know, for Vibrant Health and the PowerPoint that goes with it and the whole thing. And we'll do that again someday because, of course, it's always being updated, always being augmented. But the chemistry of the body remains the same. And I just want to thank you for taking the time and the trouble to be here today. And I hope we've shared some things that give you good food to think about, no pun intended, or pun intended, I guess. And until next week, this is Christopher Timms, Baraka Bashad. May the blessings be. Thank you very much.